Hello everybody, in this video we will just discuss how to display a view component in React Native. Okay, so see, view is a most fundamental component used in React Native while building UI. Okay, if you are familiar with HTML, then it is just like a div tag of HTML, or you can compare it with UI view of iOS or view of Android as well. Okay, so view is usually a container component. Okay, so let us discuss how to display view in emulator. Okay, so let us create our own folder first. Okay, so I am going to create a folder component. Okay, within this component folder, let us create one JS file. Okay, so I am going to create a JS file, that is welcome.js once again. Okay, now in this file we have to write a code to display view. Okay, so just like our previous program, here we have to import React. Okay, and as we know, React is in React package itself. Okay, and then we have to display view. Okay, so how to display for view is a inbuilt component. Okay, so we have to import it as well. Okay, so import. Now view is a React Native component. Okay, so let us import a view, and its definition is present in React Native. Okay, so let us give semicolon here. Now see, we have to display a view component. So as I said earlier, there are two different ways. Either you can use class component, otherwise you can use functional component. Okay, but we will just proceed with functional component method. Okay, so if you want to use functional component, then we have to define one unnamed function. Okay, and this function has to return a view. Okay, so has to return a view. Okay, so in this case, here we have to write code to display a view in emulator. Okay, so you can, before that, here you can store the, you can assign this particular function to some constant. Okay, this method, this process we have already discussed in our previous videos. Okay, so let us give name to this particular constant as, suppose, display view. Okay, fine. So in the return, here we have to write a code to display view. Okay, so how to write code? Here, see, view is a inbuilt component, as I said earlier. Okay now for a view, we can use some properties. Okay, so how to use properties for the views? This is the way, by using what we can use some properties to display view. Okay, so here we can use style. We can assign some style for this particular view. So style means, if you want to give some background color, if you want to assign some width and height, then that particular task we can perform by using style. Okay, now see, here let us give some background color for this particular view. Okay, let us give background color for this as, let us say, red, and assign some height as well for this. Okay, let us assign height for this particular view as, suppose, 70. Okay, you can use padding property as well. Padding. Okay, let us assign padding for this as 10. Okay, so here what we have done, we create one functional component. Okay, and this functional component is returning one view. Okay, a view, as I said earlier, it is just like a div tag of HTML. This is a container component. Okay, and for this view, we use a style property, and we have assigned different styles. Like, we have given background color for the view as red, then we assign height as 70, and then we have given padding as 10. Okay, so now this particular functional component we assign to this constant display view. Okay, so we have to export this display view. Okay, so how to export, we know very well. Now we have already discussed this particular point, export default, and then we have to write our constant name. Okay, fine. Now in this case, in which file we have written this code? Welcome.js file. So this component you have to register with app registry. Okay, so if you want to register this welcome.js with app registry, then you have to open index.js. So I have already registered. here see, I have already imported this welcome file, okay, from component folder, and then I have registered this welcome file with app register. Okay, now let me open welcome.js file once again. This is our welcome.js file. Okay, so let us execute this particular code. Okay, so see here, we have got output. We have got this particular view with background color red. Height, this is a height. Height is 70, and padding is actually a distance from all the borders. Okay, that is 10. Okay, now in this case, see, if you change here color, okay, suppose instead of red, if I give blue, if you save your code, just press Ctrl S, here we will get it in blue color. Okay, so you can change this property. This is just like a CSS of HTML. Okay, those changes may get reflected here, okay, automatically because of watchman config, okay, hot reload feature. Okay, now see, sometime you can you can use nesting concept in the component as well. That is, in this view we can create few more views as well. Okay, suppose this is our parent view component. Okay, so within this we can use few more view component, child view component. Okay, so if I want to use one more view component here within this, you can use it. Okay, now for that also we can assign some properties. Okay, so let us assign style for this child view as well. Okay, so how to assign? Again, for the child view we have to give some background color, so this will be treated as parent in this case. Okay, so for the child we may again give background color as, suppose for first one let us give background color as a red. Okay, and let us assign height for this particular view as, let us assign height. Okay, so parent height is 70, so this is the first child view, so let us assign height for this as, suppose 20. Okay, and then you can close this particular view. Okay, so when you save your code, you will get child view as well. Now here what is happening is, this view is a parent view, okay, and within this view we have used this child view. Okay, so for the child view we have assigned some own styles. Okay, and these are the styles of parent view. Okay, similarly you can create one more child of main parent. Okay, so you can copy and paste this particular code here itself. Okay, let us change background color for better understanding. Okay, so suppose background color for this as white. Okay, and let us keep height as 21. Okay, so see here, in the blue background, actually completely here there is a background blue, because for the parent view we have given blue background, but on this parent we have added two different child views. Okay, so for first child I have given background as red, and for second child I have given background as white. Okay, so we have got output like this. Okay, now I hope you are getting this particular point. In our subsequent videos we will discuss this view component in detail, but here I just want to give you a short introduction of this view component, because to cover a few further concept we will use this particular component, okay, in the example. Okay, so if you find any difficulty in understanding any point, then you can ask for queries through comments. So that's all for this session. Stay tuned for further updates. Thank you.